Hello friends, in this video we are going to see the application of Norton's theorem in order to find out a current flowing through a resistance which we consider as a load. So let's have a problem. So I have taken a very simple numerical having only voltage source of 10 volt and resistances, this is 1 ohm, 1 ohm, this is also 1 ohm, and this resistance we will have as 2 ohm. Objective is to get current flowing through the 2 ohm resistance using Norton's theorem. So it's a very simple numerical. Let's see how to solve. First step is calculation of IN. What we need to do? We need to replace this load resistance as a short circuit link. So replace RL, in our case it is 2 ohm, by a short circuit link. This is the only modification you have to make in the original circuit. Rest of the part of the circuit will remain same. So wherever load resistance was connected, I will name those terminals A and B. So we are supposed to find out a current flowing through this link which we denoted as IN. So I will use a mesh analysis, two loops, two loop currents, I1, I2. As per the current direction, let's mark all the voltage polarities and let's apply KVL to loop number 1. So we'll start from this point, plus minus, so minus I1, because the resistance is of a 1 ohm, plus minus, minus I1, minus plus, plus I2, and minus plus, which is 10, plus 10 equal to 0. So if I rearrange the terms, I will get minus 2I1 plus I2 equal to minus 10, equation number 1. Similarly, I can apply KVL to loop 2. So here I will start from this point, plus minus, minus I2, plus minus, one more minus I2 term, and minus plus, plus I1 equal to 0. So if I simplify, I will get I1 minus 2I2 equal to 0. This is equation number 2. Solving equations 1 and 2, I will get I1 as 6.6667 ampere and I2 as 3.3333 ampere. Now IN is same as I2. We can conclude that from the diagram IN I can write as 3.3333 ampere. So IN is same as I2, which is nothing but 3.3333 ampere, and its direction is from A to B. So step number 1 we have completed. Let's go to second step, calculation of RN. For this we need to do three things. First thing, we need to remove RL. In our case it is 2 ohm. So remove RL means we have to open circuit RL. If there is a current source present, we need to replace it by open circuit, but in our problem we are having only voltage source, and that is of 10 volt. So 10 volt voltage source is short circuited. So we will get a circuit like this, 10 volt voltage source is shorted. If I remove RL, I will get terminals A and B. Now across these terminals we are supposed to find out RN using series parallel combination. So here it's very easy. This 1 ohm and this 1 ohm are in parallel. So it is 1 into 1 divided by 1 plus 1. The answer I will get is 1 by 2, which is nothing but 0.5. And this 0.5 will come in series with this 1 ohm. So actually I will get a circuit like this. This is 1 ohm, this is equivalent 0.5 ohm and RN. Okay. So here it's very easy, 1 and 0.5 will come in series. So answer I will get is 1.5. So RN is 1 plus 0.5, 1.5 ohm. Third step, we need to draw Norton's equivalent circuit. Which consists of a current source and a resistance across it. So current source is have the value 3.3333 ampere, and Norton's resistance will be of 1.5 ohm. Now the last step is calculation of IL. For this, we need to reconnect whatever the load resistance is given. So load resistance given over here is 2 ohm, and through that resistance we have to find out IL. So we have to use current divider rule. So by current divider rule I can say IL equal to RN divided by RN plus RL multiplied by IN. So it is 1.5 divided by 1.5 plus 2 multiplied by 3.3333. So if I solve, I will get load current as 1.4286 ampere. And now for this I am getting a Norton current flowing from A to B. So here also I can write a direction from A to B. So this will be an answer for a question that is asked, what is the current flowing through a 2 ohm resistance. In subsequent videos, we will solve more numericals based on Norton's theorem. Thank you.